Hi, this is Anil and welcome to the video tutorial for the learning lad on C++ programming. In this tutorial, we're going to be learning about the constants, the variables, data types and the keywords in C++. So first, we're going to begin with the constants. As the name indicates, a constant is an entity which doesn't change. We have different types of constants. For example, we have integer constants, which is an whole number. For example, 44, or we have 86, or any whole number which is an integer constant. And then we have floating point constants, for example, 12.23, you know, a number with decimal values, 34.53, etc. So all these are floating point constants. Then we have character constants, you know, for example, a letter A or a letter B, or a letter Z, you know, character constants, single character, and a character constant is written in single quotes. And then we have string constants, which are written in double quotes, for example, Anil, and we have any other string, for example, lad, you know, which is written in double quotes, and which is a bunch of characters. These are called string constants. In computer memory, whatever we save, the values will be stored in zeros and ones. So this computer memory is divided into small bits. And the small bits are grouped to form bytes. 8 bits are grouped to form 1 byte. So it's gonna be 8 bit equal to 1 byte. The values zeros and ones are stored in these bits, 0 or 1, so something like this. And all of you know that computer memory has their own address. For example, let's say this byte has the address 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and similarly this byte is going to contain its own address. And when we store some values in our computer memory, you know, when we want to use that in our program, what we need to do is we need to refer this address or the location where our value is stored. So to access the value stored in a memory by using its address is very difficult. That's why what we're gonna do is we're gonna give a name to this memory location so that we can easily remember that and also we can easily refer that. For example, let's give a new name called X to this byte. So this name given to this memory address or the name given to the memory location is called as a variable. So a variable is nothing but the name given to a memory location in order to access it easily. So when we give a name or create a variable in our program, you know, whenever we refer to that variable, for example, y equal to 2x, you know, let's assume that y is another variable. Here, the x will refer to whatever value which is stored in this variable or the memory location referred by this variable x. So next is about the data types. So all of you know that, you know, when we store some values in our memory locations, you know, and give some name to them, you know, the compiler wants to know what type of data we are storing in that variable or the memory location. So the type of data stored in a variable is called data type. So we have integer data types, which refers to the integer constants. We have character data types, which refers to character constants. We have floating point. We have boolean. We have and one special data type is there, which is called void, which is normally used with the functions just to indicate that a particular function is not gonna return any values, you know, which we're gonna learn later in the tutorials on the functions. So a data type is nothing but what type of data is stored in a variable or a memory location. So we have integer, floating point, character, boolean, you know, which is true or false, then void, you know, which is valueless data types. And also we have some type modifiers which are used with the data types. We have signed, unsigned, short and long type modifiers, and these are used with the data types. And these type modifiers are going to influence on the number of bytes to store a particular value. For example, some compilers are going to take 2 bytes to store an integer value, and you know, some compilers are going to take 4 bytes or something like that. So when we use these type modifiers, they're going to increase or decrease the bytes or memory taken to store that particular variable of that type. Alright, the next thing is about the keywords. These keywords are nothing but the words whose meanings are already defined to our compiler. For example, to indicate that we are going to store integer value in a memory location or in a variable, we need to use the keyword int as the data type. So this int is a keyword for integers. Similarly, we have float for floating, then char for character, then bool for boolean, etc., etc. So there are many keywords available in C++, and for example, we have if, you know, whose meaning is already defined to the compiler. We have for, we have switch, and many are there. So the main thing is, we can't use these keywords, whatever keyword is there, we can't use them with our variable name. So here we have a variable name, or the name given to the memory location is called x, and here we can't give a keyword here. For example, I can't write int here, or I can't give a name int to the memory byte. Once again, a constant is an entity which doesn't change. We have integer, floating point, character, string constants. Then a variable is a name given to a memory location in order to access that easily. And then data type indicates what type of data is stored in a variables. And the keywords are the words whose meaning is already defined to the compiler, and we can't use them as the variable names. So this is it, guys. This is about some information on the constants, variables, data types, and keywords. I know my drawing is a bit ugly, so I'm really sorry for that, and thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. You guys can like my Facebook page at facebook.com/learninglad, and if you have any doubt, don't hesitate to put a comment. If you have any suggestion, please comment it, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.